What can we learn about the Americans who invest in exchange-traded funds? ICI's latest fact book offers data analysis on ETF-owning households. And our Senior Director of Retirement Investor Research, Sarah Holden, offered some highlights.
So ICI regularly publishes data on the size of the ETF market, and at our 25-year mark, there's more than $3.4 trillion in ETFs. We find that it tends to be equity investing, often in a broad-based, large-cap stock type ETF fund. So it has grown a great deal over the quarter century that they've been around. And each year we do a survey of U.S. households, and in our most recent survey we found that about 8 million households say that they own ETFs.
And you have studied mutual fund owning households for a long time. As you're now putting these two data sets together, what do you see in terms of similarities and differences?
So we see some similarities. They tend to be married, they tend to be employed, and they're often focused on saving for retirement. That said, the ETF owning households are more likely to have an IRA than the mutual fund owning households.
And they also seem to have more graduate or at least undergraduate education?
Yeah, so we find the ETF-owning households are more likely to have either a college or a postgraduate degree than the mutual fund-owning households. About half of mutual fund-owning households have college or postgraduate degrees compared to it's about two-thirds of the ETF-owning households.
Sarah, it also looks like they're less risk-averse.
Yeah, so when we ask households about their willingness to take investment risk, we see that the ETF-owning households, more than half of them say they are willing to take above average or substantial risk in the hope of gains, compared to about a third of mutual fund-owning households. And this willingness to take risk really lines up with what they're doing with their investments. They are indeed invested in the equity market. So there's a recognition that there's risk in investing in equities with the hope of the higher return, and these households have a lining up of that willingness to take risk with the investments they've chosen.
So this is a nice picture that people can now have of these markets, maybe a little bit more insight than we've offered before. And this is now in the fact book for this year?
Yeah, so we have in fact book, there's a chapter that talks about the ETF market as well as these ETF owning households. And we're continuing to analyze and look into this data.
So this is kind of an exciting area where people are used to ICI giving them so much information about so many things, and this is yet another new kind of field of data you're planting for us.
Yeah, I think, well, as the ETF industry has grown up alongside the mutual fund industry, it's just natural to start asking, are there similarities and differences between these two different pools of investors?